If you want to improve your ukulele strumming, please keep on watching, because in this video I will give you 5 ways to spice up your strumming. Before I continue, I post every week guitar and ukulele videos. If you like my content, please subscribe to my channel. For most of my tutorials, tabs and backing tracks are available at my Patreon page. You can find the link in the description of this video. And thank you if you are supporting this channel. Okay, without further ado, grab your ukulele. Okay, first some basics. Because of my guitar background, I like to strum the uke with a guitar pick. In this case, I'm using a 0.73mm light pick, like this. In my ears, it sounds the best. It's also possible to play the ukulele with special ukulele picks. I don't like these ones. I think they are too big. They don't feel natural to me. But I think that is because I'm used to guitar picks. Do what you think works best for you. You have to find out yourself. Okay, now how to hold the pick. I like to hold the pick like this. And I don't want to squeeze it too hard between my fingers, because I want a smooth sounding ukulele. And don't push too hard on the strings, because that sounds harsh. It's also possible to play these exercises with your fingers. If you don't like picks, no problem. And also practice these exercises with a metronome. It's very important to play in time. Besides that, it is a good tool to measure your improvements. Ghost notes are percussive sounds that you can play in between chords and notes. They are adding a rhythmic element to your playing. Let me give you an example. Grab a C7 chord, like this. You can mute the strings with your left hand. You have to relax your fingers. Don't push. When you push, you've got a sound. If you don't push, you don't have sound. This is a ghost note. The first beat we are going to play a full sounding chord. And 2, 3, and 4 are ghost notes. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we're going to play a chord on the second beat. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we are going to play a chord on the first beat and the fourth beat. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. And the last exercise is to play on the after beat, the second and the fourth beat. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. Triplets. The next tip builds on the ghost notes. You can also add triplet ghost notes between your chords. I'm not going to dive deep into the theory behind this, because I want to teach you it in a practical way. Again, grab a C7. When I'm playing triplets like this, I'm playing upstroke, downstroke, upstroke. And they are all ghost notes. Now, in a context. 1, 2, 3, 4, another. I count it like another. Another. 1, 2, 3, 4. Another 1, 2, 3, 4. Another 1. variation of this exercise is that you can start with the triplet. Slowly. You can also try it with different chords. The chirk. Another rhythmic element for your strumming is the chirk. When I want to play a chirk with my finger, I'm going to play the strings with my index finger and turn my hand to mute the strings. That's a chirk. And when I'm playing it with a guitar pick, I'm doing exactly the same. Turning my hand. Slowly. And now with my fingers. I'm now going to play a C chord and an F chord and back to the C. A little bit faster. And when you are doing a chuck, you can also play some ghost notes because you are muting with your right hand, like this. Slowly. Okay, now I'm going to play the C chord and an F chord with the chirk and ghost notes. Hammer-ons and slides. Another way to spice up your strumming is to add hammer-ons and slides between the beats. This will also give you a rhythmic effect. Okay, we are going to play a hammer-on on the first beat. I'm barring my finger on the third fret and I'm going to hammer my ring finger on the fifth fret of the fourth string. The only thing you have to practice is this. And then you can play every rhythm. Slowly. You can also release your ring finger when you're playing the upstroke. A variation is the slide on the first beat. Then I'm sliding from the second fret to the third fret. On the first beat. When you combine these two, okay, and then with some ghost notes. Okay, thank you for watching. I hope this video was helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and I will see you next time.